I am Himadri Lathia from PP Somani University, Semester 6, Biotechnology. My enrollment number is 17SS02BT060. My topic is Cauliflower Mosaic Virus. Cauliflower Mosaic Virus is also known as CAMV. Cauliflower Mosaic Virus is a type species of family Colymoviridae. This family is grouped together with Hepidna virus into the pararetrovirus group due to its mode of replication via reverse transcription of pre-genomic RNA intermediate. It has virus classification. Group will be group 7, order will be Otavirales, family Colymoviridae, genus will be Colymovirus, species will be Cauliflower Mosaic Virus. It was the first plant virus shown to have DNA genome and the first to replicate reverse transcriptase. It is transmitted by aphids. The member of Colymovirus gene contain 11 species and 6 possible members. It significantly implied on plant virology and plant molecular biology. The virus is an important source of gene regulatory elements used exclusively in the genetic manipulation of plants. Now, significance. Cauliflower mosaic virus has been negatively impactful worldwide. Previous studies have shown that CAMV causes a reduction of 25-59% syllable cauliflower heads in Brittany, France, as well as a reduction of 60-90% of syllable turnips in Czech Republic. Breakouts of disease can be devastating to agriculture and national economics. Studying and researching this virus could prevent disease and possibly stop the next potato famine of the cauliflower plant. Cauliflower mosaic virus possesses a highly sought-after efficient promoter for gene transcription that can be used in an effort to produce transgenic plants. Transgenic plants are used in order to receive benefits such as producing better yield, quality, as well as resistance to insect, disease, and herbicides. Currently, about 10% of cruciferous vegetables are infected with cauliflower mosaic virus in order to give the host plant pesticide resistance. Now, ecology and pathology. In order for plant viruses to enter the host genome, it must enter via mechanical transmission. This is because cell walls are too thick for some viruses to penetrate, so they rely on transmission through broken cells, animal vectors, or through their own seeds. For cauliflower mosaic virus, aphids are the most common vector for infection. Aphids possesses a needle-like mouthpiece that allows penetration into plants. Aphids then ingest the plant nutrients and sap while also leaving saliva behind in the plant. This saliva can infect the plant if the aphid contain a virus coming from a plant that was ingested beforehand. The specific aphid that transports cauliflower mosaic virus is the species Mysus persicae. This fully grown insect grown to be 1.5 to 2 mm at maturity. They can reproduce at very fast rates and appear during the warmer months to feed on plants. They are polyphagous, which means there is an array of plant species that are able to feed from. Relating to disease, Mysus persicae are known to be able to carry over 100 different types of disease such as cauliflower mosaic virus. Their poisonous saliva can transmit a vast array of disease from species to species of plant that it chooses to prey on. Now, structure. It has isoskeletal with a diameter of 52 angstrom nanometer built from 420 capsid protein subunits. It contains a circular double-stranded DNA molecule of about 8.0 kb. DNA is interrupted by site-specific discontinuous resulting from its replication by reverse transcriptase. After entering the host, the single-stranded nicks in the viral DNA are repaired, forming a supercoiled molecule that binds to histones. DNA is transcribed into a fully length. The virus particle have been crystallized. X-ray crystallography did not yield any detailed information. The structure have been shown by chiroelectron microscopy and three-dimensional image reconstruction to comprise 3 concentric layers of solvent exclusion density. Now, structure of genome. This is the structure of genome. The promoter of a 35S RNA is very strong constitutive promoter responsible for the transcription of the whole cauliflower mosaic virus gene. It is well known for its use in plant transformation. It causes high level of gene expression in dicot plants. The 35S RNA is particularly complex, containing a highly structured 600 nucleotides long leader sequence with 8 to 6 open reading frames. This leader is followed by 7 tightly arranged longer ORF that encode all the viral proteins. The mechanism of expression of the protein is unique in that the ORF protein controls translation reinitiation of major open frames on the polycystronic 35S RNA, a process that normally only happens on bacterial mRNAs. Now, replication. The viral double-stranded DNA genome is introduced via an aphid bite. Once inside the host, the viral genome is encapsulated and its DNA is transcribed by the host RNA polymerase to make a copy of viral RNA. Host river transcriptase then copies viral RNA back to DNA. Viral RNA also is used to produce gene products such as new capsid proteins and movement proteins in combination with viral DNA to assemble progeny virions. Now, immunity and prevention. In order to defend against viral infection of cauliflower mosaic virus, plants must depend on their natural defenses or risk death. In a situation using cauliflower as an example, in farms having cauliflower as a cash crop, the risk of viral infection is very high. This is because they all are grown in proximity and in the same conditions where random mutation not favored. It would not be favorable to viral resistance. Plants also must rely on their own immune system. If a plant can utilize its ability to interfere with gene expression, then virions will stop being replicated inside of the host. The plant is able to recognize foreign mRNA and stop gene expression before the plant continues producing for the virus. There is no cure for cauliflower mosaic virus. Once a plant is infected, then it is too late. Prevention is the only way to prevent agricultural or gardening losses. Since cauliflower mosaic virus is usually spread by aphids, so any sort of pest control can be beneficial in reducing infection. Now, uses of cauliflower mosaic virus. The first one is for effective transmission of cauliflower mosaic virus. The foreign DNA must be encapsulated in viral protein and the inserted gene should not interfere with native assembly of virus. Second one is the cauliflower mosaic virus does not contain any non-coding region where the foreign DNA can be inserted. But there are two genes, namely gene 2 and gene 7, have no essential function for the virus. So the gene of interest can be replaced in the place of these two genes. Attractive feature is infection is systematic and the genome has 3 discontinuities. Use of cauliflower mosaic virus as a vector pertains to the bacterial DHFR gene inserted in the place of gene 2 and successfully expressed in plant. This DHFR gene is needed for providing resistance to methotrexate. Now, limitation. Limited capacity of insertion. Infective capacity is lost if few hundreds of nucleotides are introduced. Because of its exceeding natural genome size, they are effectively suitable for gene transfer. Now, symptoms. Yellow, white or green strips, streaks, spots or foliage. Wrinkled, curled or small leaves. Pronounced yellowing only on veins. Stunted growth and reduced yields. Infected fruit appears mottled and develops raised warty areas. Now, treatment. Fungicides will not treat this viral disease. Plant resistant varieties, when available or purchase, transplants from a reputable source. Do not save seed from infected plants or crops. Spot treat with least toxic natural pest control products such as Safer Soap, Bond Neem and Diatomaceous Earth to reduce the number of disease carrying insects. It will help keep insect pest off vulnerable crops, transplants, and should be installed until bloom. Remove all perennial weeds using less toxic herbicides within 100 yards of your own garden plot. This virus can be spread through human activity, tools, and equipment. Frequently wash your hands and disinfect garden tools, stakes, ties, supports, and greenhouse benches, etc. to reduce the risk of contamination. Avoid working in the garden during damp conditions. Avoid using tobacco around susceptible plants. Cigarettes and other tobacco products may be infected and can spread the virus. Remove and destroy all infected plants. Do not decompose. That's it. Thank you.